Welcome back, everyone, for next part of Etrian Odyssey Nexus. I decided to hunt down a wolf in this part. And, well, I'm not quite sure how this is going to turn out. So, yeah. This is going to be really interesting. Especially since we need to clear out those wolves before we get noticed. Or else those guys are going to respawn the whole time, which is super annoying. Wow, that missed? Seriously? Come on. What was it? Paralyze. Of course, the one person I needed to use the skill with had to get paralyzed or stunlocked herself. Come on. These guys aren't really that strong. Right? I mean, they are just blue. It shouldn't be such a problem. Come on, let me save some TP. Just die. Okay. Now back away. Okay, that's not going to work. Let's get this one first. Blaze Link. Wind Swallow. Let's be a bit quicker about this one. And a Nerf Circle. Don't ice me! Follow, attack, attack, attack. No, don't do this. And now I can just auto attack, right? Handel. Now he howls. That isn't that strong, luckily. So, he didn't see me yet. Can I get behind him? Yes. Okay. That's the perfect layout. It's just how we want it to be. Now, I don't know about his weakness, but he's blue, so it's probably fire, maybe? Let's just hope it is. Now we can just set up with Star Drop, or maybe Head Bash. You can do Blind Arrow, and you can do this one, right? Perfect. Now we can do this with Fire, I would say, and this for a bigger boost with Twin Swallow, and you do another Head Bash. You can start multi-shot shooting, and you can put up with the Hood Circle. Yes. Bad. I hate it. Now the other things are going to spawn. But that's okay. That's still okay. Twin Swallow, Head Bash, multi-shot, and attack. Okay. Okay. Promising. Let's keep howling! Please keep howling! Wolf! Wolf is coming! Let's focus with this one. Twin Swallow. Head Bash. Multi Shot. Let's switch it up to Nerf Circle. Come on! Is he just howling? The whole time? Okay, the Nerf Circle worked. That's good. That's perfect. Attack. Attack. How about I get a head bash on him? Be awesome, you know? Stop howling! Don't you think it's annoying? Another wolf joined us. Come on, let's bind him. I think it's still okay. Stop howling! God damn it! Yes! Found it. Okay. Zack. You can do a unbind to the back nine. You going to refresh the Nerf Circle, maybe? Or maybe Charm Ice. Charm Ice for now. Don't want them to hit that much. Attack, attack, unbind the front, attack, pause, and Nerf Circle. Come on! Didn't work, okay. Everything is fine, everything is fine. Those wolves aren't so bad. And my force is at 40%. So I just need to wait out. How are my items? Do I have something? I have a lot of nectars? Confusion gas. That work? Let's wait out. Going to extend this charming eye. It is still bounded. Perfect. Another one paralyzed. Oh god. Spell. Let's refresh. Oh, the next wolf is about to join us. Great! And he's already at half. That was my force. Still no good. Okay. Unbind the front. Attack. Or maybe... Oh, let's protect a bit. And... you have... Oh, you do not. Stop binding me, please. Ooh, you can do ice as well. Good to know. And it's quite powerful. Better use a claw server for you, huh? And another little heal for Danny. With this and this. Okay. Wow, Levi! Levi, your tank! You're a pure tank! What's the force? 65%, 80%. That's still okay. Mirage Arrow! And, how about a Hood Circle, maybe? Hood Circle? Yeah, Hood Circle. Wow! That did a lot of damage! Don't bind me! Don't stun me! Don't stun me! Perfect! Hood Circle? One at least. 78%, 90%. Okay. Still manageable. How about a blind arrow? And you can do another charming eyes. Don't want you guys to do damage! Okay, everything's fine. No headband. Ooh, god! I really hope those wolves go away once I'm in that thing. Yes, but I need to wait a tiny bit more. A tiny bit more. Blind arrow. The other ice skill. Please don't kill. Please don't kill. Please don't kill. Please don't kill. Good. And bite. Great. Now I can switch up again. 80%. 90%. Let's cure everyone this turn and. Wait, bad idea. You use this. You use a Great Warrior, maybe on yourself. You use Intense Healing Touch. You are going to use a normal attack. You are going to use a Nerf Circle. Right. So now we are healed. Benny died, I shouldn't have used that other skill. But it's okay, it's okay. After all, we have Rhei with her ultimate power. And of course we have Levi and Evie. We're going to help! I mean, would help! They are not helping! Base. Vive. Multishot. Attack. Come on! Yes! Yes! Don't kill her! Don't kill her! Good! It's okay, we can still do this. Force a break. Claw Sever. Heal Danny. Blind Shot. Christmas Heal. Yes. Heal a bit. What? Ah, oh, Evie! Why did you die? Why did you have to die? Okay. I got the boost. Twin Swallow. Heal, Alicia. You are going to use a Nectar on Evie. Come on! Don't stun anyone! Yes! Lot of damage! Shoot! Multi shot. Medica 2. Or maybe Soma. Better. Confusion gas. You have a high chance to do this, right? You have a lot of luck! Please! Please do it! Kinda worked! Echo Blade. Healing Line. Multishot? And a Soma. Screw you! My both healers! Oh god! Yes! No! Alicia! Alicia is getting XP! No! The gap has been risen again. Oh! At last! Fenrir succumbed to a final powerful blow. A huge beast let out a dying wheeze, then stops moving. The goddess of victory has smiled upon you. Great tree preserve. You've done it. Thank you, Vesperia. With Fenrir defeated, we should be able to handle the rest. You should get to the tavern and retrieve your reward. You were truly amazing out there. Thank you so much. You may head back to the tavern if you like, or continue to explore the maze. Whew! God damn. That took forever. But at least we beat it, right? At least we managed to beat it somehow. Seems like there are a few water puddles around. A lot of them. All around the corners, huh? Okay. Let's throw those out. And done? Ah, no, not right. There's something, more like this. Probably like this. And we're done here. And we're almost killed during the process. So better are we going to escape from here right now, right? But since we have Baby alive with his stalker skill, we could just walk safely out without any worries. Please, I need to sell that. Sell everything. Wolf King helmet. What's that? Headbind resistance. And decent defense. Cool. So, now that we have rested, let's see what our reward is going to be. Except the Nectar 2. I mean, it's still useful, but yeah. Hey, welcome back! You did a good job! What's that? How do I know? Well, when you are a request giver, like me, you get a special psychic power that can sense when someone finished a request. I'm just kidding. I can tell by the look on your face that you finished it up. I've got a good eye for reading expression. With Fenrir gone, those wolves should start to settle down again. Peace has finally returned to our beautiful city. And for the brave heroes, a reward for completing the request. Excellent work. How much XP? So little? So little? Really? The next one is the one with the FOE, the wolf, and I kinda hate doing this. Better we do the FOE one first, right? It's better for my health. So, I think it would be the best decision to go for the first one, right here. Maybe if he isn't looking at us. Oh, he's always going to look at us. Okay. So, Rebel Wolf, I have no idea what you can do. So, improve. Great Warrior. Head Bash. Line Arrow. Astonishing Eye. Perfect. Oh, what was that? Okay, we're not going to use fire against you. Twin Swallow. Head Bash. Multishot and... probably a Hood Circle. Head Bash, perfect. Oh my god! Stop that! Recircle. Wind Swallow. Head Bash. Multishot. What does he have? Probably add a Charming Eye on that. Yeah, that's better this way. Now we have a problem. Head Bash, still up. Blind Arrow. Please don't. Sealed, perfect. And swallow this blind arrow. Boss. Christmas here, maybe? Or. No, I need another Strophic Ice. Ooh, damage. Damage. Please. Twin Swallow. Head Bash. Drache Arrow. Charming Eyes, right? Charming Eyes. Come on. Be a good little dog. And let's just kill you. Please. Head Bash. Pretty short. Let's reset his resistances. Ooh, damage. Damage, damage. So now that we did that, should be possible for me to blind him again, right? Let's try a circle again. Perfect. Perfect. So I have a feeling he only used that fire attack if he has a status element. Because he always uses it when he misses a lot. But that could just be my imagination. Well, I'm just lucky, and he never got a chance to use it without the other effect. Either way, he's almost dead. Just a tiny bit more. And of course, now he needs to bind her. What bind is it? Black bind. Oh, that's bad. It's actually bad. Oh well. I'm just gonna do what I always do. Come on, just die. Perfect. Beast Fawn. You've collected the fawn. All that remains is to complete the quest. Well, that was kinda easy. It took all of my TP. Let's just hope the XP we're going to get is worth it. Let's just hope. And I don't really want to do the raccoon quest, but I guess that's the next one I'm going to finish up. Glad to see you in one piece. Wow, this thorn sure is something. It's almost like metal. So heavy and sharp. You could slice a finger off if you're not careful. Seems like a little off the top to make a prosthetic hand out of this material. Dangerous even. Wait, that's it? He really is going to put a hidden weapon into it. Wow, he's so cool! Right then, here's your reward. Hope you'll come by for another one. XP? Thank you. Is there another one? No. Just a hair clip one? Anything new here? Cheating. What am I so mad about? About Bloom. Is that just when you think you got it licked? It goes and eats another monster whole. Not only does it heal the damage you dealt, but it powers the thing up. An absurd amount. Eh? Saying we powered up too? Well, we are people. We are allowed to do it. You know the method to acquire a pierced will? It's a mysterious bill-shaped organ within a snail monster. Normally, it's with us, so a useless calm and once the monster is defeated. However, if you are agile enough to snap the organ with a stab attack, you'll acquire it before it's in any condition to disappear. In layman's term, the trick is to get a piercing will is to finish off all snail monsters with a stab attack. So that means it's Levi's job. I sold everything, right? No, not everything. And I have a thread, right? Yes. Yes, I'm going to heal up and do some grinding. For the raccoon, you know? I need to get that raccoon thing out of the way. And after that, I guess there's nothing in the way to go for the shell monster. Except, of course, we are too weak. If we are too weak, then we're going to have a problem. Maybe I even need to switch off my party. For once. Huh. Oh god. That's going to be fun. Ah, hello! Raccoons, of course! Instantly free of them! And what about that conditional drop I didn't get of you guys? Round body, apparently something... that sometimes fall asleep. Flaceful deaths. Wait, what? I can blind them, I can turn them to stone, and I can leg bind them. Question is, what is more useful? Changing spell, flame spell. I don't want one of them to be left alive. So better. I mix it up a bit, right? How about a leg bind for everyone? Please don't be so strong. Leg bind. How about we kill the one first? This one. We're going to kill this one first. We can take care of the behind, the other one there, like this. Then we can use Charming Eye to make them a tiny bit weaker. Okay. Normal attack, attack, power shot, attack. One is dead. It's So, now we focus a tiny bit more on the... Wait. Mining here. Now we focus a tiny bit more on the... bad guy. Before he transforms. Don't want that thing to transform at all. At least until I'm able to safely kill him, you know? Don't want to deal with that. Charming Ice refreshed. Don't do that. Don't do that. Just be quiet and adorable little raccoons, okay? Just be... Wait, what can I use against you? Sleep, right? Right. Libby! You're almost dead! You're not supposed to die! Come on! Ooh! Close one. So now that thing is going to transform, but I don't care about that, because he needs at least one turn to do that. But he didn't do it! I didn't get the hairpin. Oh, so that's supposed to be different. It's a tanuki and Huh. Okay. Guess I need to find the right spot for this quest. So, I think I figured it out. Rather, I took a sneak peek on the internet and figured out where I'm supposed to go. The answer was, there's a little way on the fourth floor of this dungeon. There's a little dead end right around this corner here. And here it is. Following the request received at Napier's firm, your party walks across searching for a tanuki wearing a hair clip. You soon spot a small hole in the ground ahead of you. Based on the tanuki you've seen in the labyrinth, you determine that one of their dens would be about that size. Figuring you have nothing to lose, you take out the trap you bought and set it up in front of the hole. Being a simple box trap, it takes no time at all to prepare. All that remains now is to wait for the tanuki to spring in. After some time, your patience is rewarded and a single tanuki shows up. You also spot the hair clip on its head. Fitting the description you receive from Napier, it's probably safe to say that tanuki is the target. The tanuki stares at the box that's sitting in front of its home, clearly fascinated by it. After hesitating for a while, it seems to notice something that intrigues it and touches the box. As it does, instead of capturing the tanuki, box falls open, exposing its content. Inside is a variety of fruit and meat, all of which are safe for tanuki to eat. You suspect they are spiked with tranquilizer, so you decided to wait and see what happens. However, no matter how long you watch it, the tanuki continues to gobble up food like nothing's the matter. Sensing something's off, you decided to approach the tanuki. To your surprise, the tanuki doesn't show fear when you see it. Rather, it openly approaches. Not only that, but it rubs up against your leg, like it wants attention. Thinking that this isn't the behavior of a thief, you find yourself more and more confused. At any rate, you've got the tanuki for the request. You decided to take it back to Napier's firm. At first, you hold it tight for fear that it might run away. doesn't struggle one bit. In fact, it seems quite happy in your arms. There's no point in thinking about it any longer. You should just take it to an appears firm. Somehow, I have the feeling that the tanuki is her pet. I mean, it's way too easy to catch. And the trap wasn't really a trap, it was just some food. So that it got blurred out. And that there wasn't anything inside of it, so... yeah. Either ways, I'm going to see you guys back in town. Since I don't want to waste 100 N. So, we are back. Let's see what's up with the tanuki. Oh, I need to give it to her personally, okay. Well, not here. Ah, it's you. Wait. Is that... That Pia grabs the tanuki out of your hands. The hair clip tumbles from its fur to the ground. Silly little thing. I can't believe you caused so much trouble for me. I'm glad I don't have to worry about you anymore. Thank you very much for your assistance. I'll handle the rest of this affair, so please, go and report your success to the... Kavzir. Pick up the hair clip. I suppose I don't need it, so you may take it. I only want a tanuki anyway. Oh, alright, the hair clip wasn't very important. Will you give it back to me? Fine, I'll explain. Just stop gazing. Just stop looking at me with that suspicious gaze. The truth is, not too long ago I traveled with another guild to the Southern Shrine. That is where I meet this tanuki. As you can tell, it's quite fond of people. Just like now, I picked up the darling creature and gave it some food. But just as we were bonding, one of the guild's adventurer scouts came running back, shouting about a monster. He completely scared off the little one. I'm used to it in combat, so I cannot blame the adventurer for doing as he did. I was merely worried that this tanuki may have found himself in danger. I figured the quickest way to find him was to have you search for the clip I put in his fur. So I submitted a request and voila! Befurio and I did. Thank you very much for your help. There. That was the whole story. Are you satisfied now? Then get yourself to the tavern and pick up that reward. Are you going to keep it? What? Why would I keep a soft, fluffy, cute... Ah! You've got 2 ears, don't you? I say go to the tavern! You're so going to keep it, right? It's way too cute to just let it go. Ooh, let's see what we get as a reward. Good work! What did she want you to retrieve? What? A tanuki? Who went and captured the tanuki? Then when you gave it to her, she was treating it with love and care? Ah, not asking me out is one thing, but did she really have to go and rub it in my face with a blessed tanuki? Some people say I'm playful as a tanuki, but apparently I don't compare to the real thing. Maybe I should be more foxy instead. Right then, day one of Foxy Kavir. Let's get it started by handing you that reward. Not sure how it's going to go, but oh well. Thank you. A thing. Is that all there is? No quest left. Nothing here either. So we killed the wolf. So there's absolutely nothing in the way between us and that giant turtle thing. So in the next part, we're going to beat that giant turtle. I hope. I'm not sure how strong it is.